Hi everyone, in this series of video, we're going to talk about spring mass damper system. In this system, we set up one spring and one damper. One end of the spring and the damper is connected to a fixed wall, and the other end is connected to a mass. The mass is restricted to only move in the horizontal direction, and this figure will record the position of the mass over time. This is what we call an output of the system. Here we also have three bars that control the properties of the parameters of the system. Each of them is for spring constant K, damping coefficient B, and input force F, which can be applied on the mass. We'll use them later. The mass is said to be 10 kg, and in the simulation, we will not change the mass. Okay. First, let's look at the simplest system, the spring and mass system without any damping. So we set the damping to be zero, the input force to be zero, and the spring constant to be 100 newton per meter. As you have learned from class, the motion of the mass should be free oscillation, which means that the mass will oscillate, but the amplitude does not change over time. The spring has been pulled 0.5 meter out to the right from its equilibrium position now. So let's go ahead and click run. As you can see, the mass is released and the oscillation starts. This sinusoidal curve recorded on this figure represents the oscillation movement. Since we pulled the spring out for 0.5 meter to the right, it will swing back to 0.5 meter to the left, as there's no damping and energy is conserved. You can tell from the figure by finding the amplitude, which is measured by peak to valley, remain the same over time. You can also find out the period of oscillation from the time interval between peak to peak. It is about 2 seconds. We can also calculate the period analytically. Recall that natural frequency omega equals to square root of k over m, and therefore period can be expressed as t equals to 2 pi over omega equals to 2 pi times square root of m over k. You can plug in numbers, k equals to 100, m equals to 10, and find out t equals to 1.98 seconds. That is close to what we observed, so our theoretical result matches with our simulation result. The free oscillation is the simplest situation. The system only contains spring and mass, but no damper. Neither the amplitude nor the period changes over time. You can change the spring constant and see how it affects the frequency of the system. Find the period from the simulation and see if it matches with your calculation.